Considering a heat pump system for your home? Whether for a retrofit or a new building, these frequently and sometimes not so frequently asked questions might help. I get questions that apply to a large number of use cases or sometimes apply just to one specific use case. I wish I could deep dive into all of these. In this video, we'll focus on four topics: cold climate heat pumps, tank heating systems, economic viability of heat pump systems, and refrigerants. I'm Kata. Welcome to my ePoint. Question number one: do cold climate heat pumps work? Or do cold climate heat pumps really work down to minus 30 degrees centigrade? And do they really cost less than a furnace to operate? As furnace oil has increased incredibly high during the last 20 years, I'm thinking seriously about switching to a cheaper operating system. After a lot of reading and research, I came down with two alternatives: air-to-water heat pump or a geothermal system. The average winter night temperature is around minus 16 degrees centigrade during January and February, with low peak periods of minus 25 degrees centigrade. What is your thought on those two scenarios? To address the question air-to-water versus geothermal, I created a video, but what about the skepticism on cold climate heat pumps? First of all, when we refer to cold climate heat pumps, we typically mean air source heat pumps that work in cold climates, both air-to-air and air-to-water. Of course, ground source systems work most efficiently, however, they also have the highest upfront cost. I'm a huge fan of air-to-water systems because they usually serve a sweet spot of very high efficiencies and affordable upfront cost. To answer the question if cold climate heat pumps work very well in cold climates, we can look at the COP, the coefficient of performance at the lowest annual temperatures. Researchers at Oxford University and the Regulatory Assistance Project, RAP, linked in the description below, found that not only do heat pumps have superior efficiency compared to oil and gas furnaces, but they also perform reliably in temperatures well below 0 degrees centigrade or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. Typical COP values for heat pumps are in the range of 3 to 6, indicating that 3 to 6 units of heat are created from each unit of electricity used. A year-round average COP of 3 to 4 is common for household applications. The researchers looked at air source heat pump performance in mild cold climates in Canada, China, Germany, Switzerland, the US, and the UK. They plotted average COP measurements versus external temperature collected from 7 field testing studies in 5 countries. A trend line calculated using a locally weighted scatter plot smoothing is shown in the chart. They concluded when the outside temperature was between 5 degrees centigrade and minus 10 degrees centigrade, the mean COP across all systems was 2.74 and the median was 2.62, sufficient to meet all heating loads at much higher efficiencies than fossil heating and electric resistance heat alternatives. At minus 15 degrees centigrade, so 5 degrees Fahrenheit, the COP is at about 2, so 200% efficiency across the board. At minus 20 degrees centigrade, so minus 4 degrees Fahrenheit, the COP is at about 1.8. I think this is amazing. Below minus 20 degrees centigrade, the COP drops down to 1.3, for some models at down to minus 25 Fahrenheit, so minus 32 degrees centigrade. I mean, this is incredible. I don't know what else to tell you. It is simply amazing that you can get 130% efficiency at such low temperatures. The other thing to keep in mind is that good systems charge their batteries or water tanks for thermal storage during the day, which means that in most northern US and Canada regions, you don't even get to these low temperatures, and can use solar panels to charge your storage. I'm not sure if it can get any better than this. But what happens if the temperature ever falls below 20 degrees centigrade? Then they have a backup resistor, pretty much like a toaster. Just hot wires, simple as that. Which means they fall back on close to 100% efficiency, all electric. Before we move on to the next question, I'd like to let you know that I'm trying to bring more of your heat pump system installation experiences on the channel. So if you have a heat pump system installed, are going to install one, air source, air to water, or geothermal, that you'd like to share your experience with others, let me know, reach out. By the way, from an environmental perspective, do electric heat pumps actually reduce emissions in Wisconsin, where coal is still on the grid? Yes. Heat pumps installed today in Wisconsin produce fewer lifetime emissions than a gas or a propane furnace, even if you run a grid-tied heat pump where coal is still on the grid. Question number two, is a tank heating system recommendable? Yes. Simply yes, unless you install a ground source system. For both geothermal and horizontal ground source heating systems, you don't need it because there is a constant temperature underground that provides warm water and heating year-round. If you are decided on an air source system, I recommend an air-to-water system using a water tank for thermal storage. I think the water tanks are a bit overpriced, but very well worth it anyway. There are three main advantages for a tank heating system. Advantage number one, your operational costs go down significantly because you tap into higher efficiency as you heat your water during the day at a warmer outside temperature. Advantage number two, in many places you can tap into lower electricity prices if you are on a time of use plan because your system can help the utility to flatten the duck curve. Advantage number three, if you are running on a grid-tight system that is not fully decarbonized, you can help reduce emissions even more. Question number three, is a clean heating and cooling system really worth it? Meaning, is it really financially viable? Sometimes I wonder if people think anything that is clean must also be more expensive. It really depends. I regularly present lifetime cost calculations for various systems on the channel. In most cases, the higher upfront cost for a ground source or an air-to-water heat pump system pays off at a fraction of the lifetime of the system, including inflation and the time value of money. One of the most important things for a heat pump installation, however, is finding a good contractor. They will get you the long-term savings. Also, I wouldn't only look at prices. It is easy to underestimate comfort, air quality, and peace of mind when it comes to long-term heating and cooling decisions for you and your loved ones. Question number four, which refrigerant to use? Or what criteria to watch out for in heat pumps other than efficiency, price, and load? The refrigerant is one of them. If you can, try to install a heat pump that uses CO2. While there are currently heat pumps operating with various working media in the market, several of these may be considered the most popular. Those commonly used in household solutions surely include hydrofluorocarbons, also referred to as fluorinated greenhouse gases, including R410A, R134A, and R407C, etc. Luckily, natural agents are attracting more and more interest. R290, propane, as well as R744, carbon dioxide, are among those worth mentioning. If you have a burning question that was not on this video, please forgive me and let me know in the comments below. If you liked this, I'd very much appreciate a thumbs up. Since YouTube ad revenue is negligible with respect to the time I put into the videos, I'd highly appreciate your support on Patreon, linked below, where you can get all of my videos completely ad-free. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.